One shall stand, one shall fall.
Halo sahabat Sport TV, selamat datang di channel olahraga yang mengulas dan menyajikan secara informatif dan inspiratif. Rumble in the Jungle adalah pertandingan antara Muhammad Ali melawan Josh Foreman. Laga ini dilangsungkan di Kinshasa, Zaire pada tanggal 30 Oktober 1974. Pertandingan ini adalah laga perebutan gelar juara tinju kelas berat undisputed atau kelas berat sejati WBC dan WBA, di mana Josh Foreman adalah sebagai juara bertahan dan Muhammad Ali sebagai penantang peringkat pertama. Big Josh Foreman, itulah julukan petinju yang satu ini. Kehebatan dan kekuatan pukulannya tidak usah diragukan lagi. Petinju ini begitu ditakutin lawan-lawannya. Betapa tidak, hanya Big Josh Foremanlah yang mampu mengalahkan dengan KO semua petinju-petinju papan atas seperti Giorgio Peralta, Josh Cuffalo, dan bahkan para petinju yang tercatat pernah mengalahkan Muhammad Ali seperti Joe Frazier, Ken Norton, dihabisinya dengan KO. Sudah tak tersisa lagi petinju-petinju papan atas yang bertengger karena semua sudah dihabisinya. Big Josh Foreman dijuluki sebagai Raja KO. Ia memiliki rekor bertanding 40 kali menang dengan 37 kali menang KO dan tanpa pernah terkalahkan. Bursa taruhan dan prediksi para pengamat tinju memberikan perhitungan nilai 4 berbanding 1 untuk Josh Foreman. Tinju dunia menganggap Muhammad Ali sebagai underdog dan tidak akan mampu mengalahkan Big Josh Foreman. Big Josh Foreman dikenal sebagai petinju dengan tipe pendiam dan anti sosialita. Dalam setiap wawancara dia tidak banyak bicara. Pantas bagi dia untuk mendapat julukan The Silent Assassin. Oke sahabat Sport TV, mari kita saksikan pertandingannya.
We're just about ready to begin round one, the heavyweight championship of the world at stake. One thing we want to look out for is just how fast this man George Foreman will open. As we mentioned in his past.
Ronde pertama dimulai. Di menit-menit awal kedua petinju saling menjajaki kemampuan masing-masing. Tak berlangsung lama, kedua petinju saling berbalas pukulan. Beberapa pukulan Ali masuk mengenai wajah Foreman, dan ini membuat Foreman sedikit terkejut. Josh Foreman terus merangsak maju terus dengan memberikan pukulan-pukulan mematikannya. Sementara Ali hanya berusaha bertahan dengan menutupi tubuhnya dan wajahnya dengan double covernya, sambil sesekali melepaskan pukulan ke Foreman.
Ronde kedua. Pada ronde kedua ini pertarungan lebih sengit lagi. Foreman terus merangsak masuk dengan pukulan kerasnya. Berkali-kali Muhammad Ali terpojok di sudut ring, namun sesekali membalas pukulan. Di menit-menit akhir, Ali mengejek Foreman untuk memancing kemarahannya. Foreman pun terpancing dan terus bertubi-tubi melayangkan pukulan.
Foreman tries to work the body. Neither one of those punches did any damage. None of those punches are doing any damage at all. None Absolutely none. There's a light flicking left hand to the face of George Foreman. Foreman pushing the head back of Ali. Hangs on. This hanging on tactic is important for Muhammad Ali, who must take a breather now and then. Left hand, light left, taken on the chin of Ali. The wild left hand is not scoring, not getting through. Left jab right in the button, thrown by Ali. Another left jab. Ali showing his flinching speed as Foreman continues. Punches are not hurting him that he's taking on the side of the head. 30 seconds left in round two. Look at Ali. Continues to taunt and talk. Definitely serious. Tremendous combination by Muhammad Ali. It's a left hand and then a straight right to the jaw. He's trying to do the damage with the left jab, a lightning flicking left to the right eye of George Foreman. 10 seconds left in round number two. Now he's pulling what he did against Joe Frazier. Shaking his head. No, no, he says. The left hand gets through again. There's the bell, ending round two.
An incredible round. What did you make of that, Joe Frazier?
Still good round.
Ronde ketiga, kembali Foreman terus mengejar Ali sampai ke sudut ring. Nampaknya Muhammad Ali berhasil memancing kemarahan Josh Foreman. Sesekali Ali membalas dengan pukulan strike and jab-nya. Foreman adalah petinju yang tahan pukul dan Ali sangat menyadari hal itu. Ali membiarkan dirinya bersandar di tali ring dan membiarkan Foreman terus menggempur dirinya.
I would say George is rushing himself too much. He needs to take his time, watch what he's doing.
Behind the fight is here, we'll ask him in the next round.
Here we go, round four, Muhammad Ali looks to be the
first. Ronde keempat, kembali Josh Foreman terus menggempur Ali. Ini adalah strategi dari Ali untuk melemahkan stamina Foreman. Jebakan bagi Foreman. Pada ronde ini nampak bahwa Foreman mulai putus asa karena tidak dapat memukul KO Ali. Dia mulai tak terarah dan asal pukul saja.
Staggered, Foreman staggered, definitely. Right on the button, right on the jaw of Jordis, around the right eye, but below the right eye. Wild right hand thrown by Foreman, misses the intended target, the jaw of Ali. Foreman tries to score, Ali ties him up in tight. Zach Clayton doing the job, separating the fighters. Ali rifle circling as we expected. Ali hanging tough, not coming in and moving out. Left hand misses, goes over the shoulder of Ali, and again Ali hangs on. Zach Clayton, the referee, separates the two fighters. There's the vicious left. No real serious damage done. Ali is getting his hand up. The wild left by the jaw of Ali. Look at Foreman's face. He does look tired. He doesn't have the bounce in his legs. Misses again. The bell ends round four.
The stadium is intense. John Daly, responsible for bringing this fight into being with Hank Schwartz and Don King. Is it living up to your expectations, John Daly?
It is absolutely.
And for us was for the referee, right?
I would say Zach did a very good job. Especially
here we go.
Ronde kelima, Muhammad Ali kembali dengan strateginya yaitu menguras tenaga lawannya hingga kelelahan. Dan ini sekali lagi tak pernah disadari oleh Pichos Foreman. Foreman terus memukul dan berusaha untuk segera mengakhiri pertarungan ini.
Ali continues left to your screen. Ali on the right. Ali leans up against the ropes. Right hand taken on the gloves by Ali. There's a real wild right hand taken in the back of the head of Ali. Foreman with a wild right again. Ali looks like he's trying to rest in this round. Punches are not doing any damage though. Vicious right thrown to the body of Ali. Wild right misses the head of Ali. The left taken on the glove of Ali, the right glove.
Foreman pouring. 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 Foreman trying to set him up. Trying to set him up to the body.
How did you read that one, Jim?
George, you remember when I fought him in?
Ronde ke-6. Pada ronde ini Josh Foreman nampak sudah sangat kelelahan sekali. Pukulan terdahsyat yang terkenal sudah tak nampak lagi. Dan dia seolah-olah memukul seadanya. Pada ronde ini, Ali beberapa kali meneriakkan ke Foreman agar memukulnya. Dia ingin Foreman tampil lebih bagus lagi.
They're still screaming back and forth about the ropes, whether they want them tight or loose. Zach Clayton separates the two fighters. Ali goes headhunting again. Oh, great left hand taken on the face of George Foreman. Ali scored 3 in a row that time. Foreman's of delivering at any time. A minute left in round 6. Muhammad is allowing Foreman to come in on him, inviting him in and counter-punching, inviting him in. And booming punches from Foreman. Neither fighter has been down. Round 6. All right.
The ropes, everyone is saying get off the rope, but I think he's resting. He knows that Foreman is basically spent. I think he's going to try to take it as far as he can and then try to knock him out.
Do you think Foreman is in that bad a shape?
I think he's fighting foolish. I don't think he's in bad shape.
Ronde ke-7. Pada ronde ke-7 ini Josh Foreman sudah sangat kelelahan, seakan tak mampu lagi melayangkan pukulan-pukulannya. Ali memegang kendali penuh. Sebenarnya pada ronde ini Ali sudah bisa memukul KO Foreman, namun tidak dia lakukan. Muhammad Ali ingin pertarungan ini menjadi dramatis dan sangat menghibur bagi pemirsa dan para pecinta tinju di dunia.
The left hand again in the face of Foreman. Definitely Ali is scoring more punches than George Foreman. The punches to the body of Ali are not hurting him. They're not taking a toll. The man is in tremendous physical condition in that part of his body. Of course. George Foreman tries to work again inside on Ali. Ali pushes his hand away. Again, Ali ties up George Foreman. Foreman doesn't look to have a good bounce on his leg anymore. Ali continues to talk. Foreman tries to deliver some shots to the body. The bell sounds, ending round 7.
He seems to have the whole fight in control. George Foreman seems to have nothing left at this time. Ali seems to be waiting, as I said earlier.
Man can take a punch out, can take you out with one punch.
But George is fighting fully.
Here we go, the bell sounds, round number 8.
Ronde ke-8. Di ronde inilah pelatihnya D'Angelo Dandy menginstruksikan Muhammad Ali untuk mengkanvaskan juara tinju dunia kelas berat tak terkalahkan, yaitu Josh Foreman. Sepanjang karirnya, Foreman tidak pernah terpukul jatuh, bahkan terkalahkan. Dan ini merupakan kekalahan yang pertama yang dialaminya.
Rumble in the Jungle, dunia seakan tak percaya dia Muhammad Ali mengalahkan petinju terhebat di masanya. Dia Muhammad Ali yang dianggap underdog dan direndahkan membuktikan bahwa dia adalah juara yang sebenarnya. Rumble in the Jungle, pertandingan ini dinobatkan sebagai pertandingan terbesar di abad 20. Hari itu 30 Oktober 1974, Muhammad Ali telah menorehkan tinta emas dan akan selalu dikenang sepanjang masa dalam sejarah tinju dunia.
Muhammad, you told me in Deer Lake you were the greatest of all time, and I think everybody out there watching now will say that you've proved it tonight.
A man who was bearing me up, too power, too strong. I proved that Allah is God.
That's right.
Elijah Muhammad is a messenger.
That's right.
And I have faith in them. And regardless of the world and the pressure, I made it an easy night. Because Allah has power over all things. And if you believe in him,
assalamu alaikum to all the Muslims. Thanks to Almighty God Allah. I want all of you fans out there who believe in me, read the Muhammad Speaks newspapers, go to your local Muslim temple and learn more about the life-giving power from Allah through Elijah Muhammad that I've got. You saw all the white people, the critics, the world had me ranked to go down. This was their man, and Allah, God, was with me, and this man looked like nothing.
Right.
I want you to remember that.
Well,
want to know where I get the power? Visit your local Muslim mosque. Read that Muhammad Speaks newspaper.
Right.
Take it from me.
That just proves you say that this at this moment,
is
this the happiest moment of your life?
No, no. Happiest moment of my life when I met Elijah Muhammad, the freedom speaker of black people. But I told you, I'm the real champion. I told you, I'm the champion of the world. All of you bow, all of our critics crawl, all of you suckers who write the rain magazine.
One shall stand, one shall fall.